Hello, everyone, and welcome back to a new episode of Invisible Ink. Let's get started here.
The mouse takes the cheese. Snap.
Target resolved.
He's very excited.
How the hell did they keep that hidden?
Plot a direct course. Thank you, monster.
Thank me later. I'll meet you there. I've got to see this rig in person.
Operator, ready the team. This is going to be a wild ride.
Okay, so as expected, we have made it to the final mission. Yes, Omni mainframe, very good. I think we have upgrades to buy, yes, good. We bought a Buster Chip 4. Is that our second EMP3? I don't remember. Oh yes, and I bought charge packs for this railgun. Alright, I gotta settle back into things here. Figure out what it is we have that we actually need. The EMP packs are just a lot less useful because I don't think there are any safes. I mean, they're fine for cameras. Okay. So who, first of all, am I giving this railgun to? I don't know. Prism? Seems as good as anyone. Sure. Who has big stims? That's the kind of thing you might want a stim for. To be able to attack twice or something. Tony has a Stim 3, so we could give that to her as well. I don't really need accelerator chips. She has some big weapons, doesn't she? Maybe I'll just take this and give it to Tony. And then, I mean, he's already got the AP penalty from being Tony, right? So that doesn't seem like such a great plan. I guess we don't need to sell that exactly, unless it's going to help us with making it to another upgrade of something. Speaking of upgrades, what are we buying? Basically hacking and nothing else, right? Yeah, and selling an accelerator chip is not going to help us with that. The Microslam apparatus, though, we can safely sell. It's doing us no good at all. Right, we wanted to take his Stim 3, put it here. Take away her med gel. She actually, if anyone's going to survive, it'll be her. That's the idea, right? So instead, give her Buster Chip to... I guess Tony's fine, why not? Decker's got some serious weaponry going on. I think I'll... Look, everyone's got good guns. I'm happy with that, I guess. It just means that I don't know exactly how to reorganize things. I guess we'll give Tony these things, and Rush can have this. And everyone's basically fully kitted out. We don't need to worry about burden because we're not really going to be taking anything home with us for sale, or buying anything at any shops. And if we do, you know, we can sell a charge pack or whatever. So I think that we're all set.
We don't know much about this facility, but if Monster is correct, it holds the most powerful computer system in the world. We need to get down there and plug Incognita into that mainframe. She'll have root access to SecNet, and we'll be able to cover our tracks. Monster and I will be joining the infiltration team. We have the tools and the expertise needed to do the AI transfer, and there's no sense in holding back now. This will be our final test. They hit us hard, and we've only had 72 hours to crawl back from the brink. But I have faith in the team we've rebuilt. Don't make me look foolish for believing in you, Operator. Let's go.
Wow, that is a long speech. And also, they didn't change it for the expansion pack, because we haven't had 72 hours. We've had 120 hours, right? 3 days is how long it was in the original game, but then the expansion adds 2 more days, which, if I can do any math, does indeed add up to 120. Okay, so here we are. Here's the big old room you beam into with all 6 agents.
I've forgotten how much I dislike the transport beam.
1-0-1-1. Shutting down.
Damn it. I'll try to do a manual restart, but it's going to hurt.
Welcome to the Incog System's Climate Modeling Platform. System date is June 27, 2045. Would you like to update the system date?
She's back, but there's no telling how long she's going to stay lucid. We need to work fast.
There should be a security hub somewhere on this level. I can get us into the central server room from there.
Okay. Finally, we're allowed to play the game. I mean, I could have skipped that stuff, but we've been mostly listening to the story this whole game, so no time to stop now. Okay, so find the security hub. Yeah. Do all the stuff you gotta do on this mission. Very good. And Monster did come back with his extra weapon, right? Yeah, the weapon we stole from him. We got another copy. And what does Central have? She's got the... she's got Incognita. Okay. So, I see two doors and a console. So, we need to check we need to check these things out. Send someone back to the console. Probably Prism. Actually, we gave... Like, Decker has max hacking, right? Slightly better this way. And someone has the accelerator chip, don't they? Rush. Now, so the optimal thing to do would be to... Well, watch. I'll show you. It's terrible. Tony, please drop a med gel. Decker, please drop a shock trap. And then, Rush, we gotta pass this along. Taking back, say, I don't know, a buster chip. And then we'll pass this over further. Taking back, say, a buster chip. Oh, he can't use it, never mind. A tag pistol. Now everybody pick up your stuff, and we've accomplished moving the accelerator chip by two tiles without costing anyone any moves, but like, geez, what oh, did I do it wrong? No, I did it right. Everyone's got full inventory. The thing moved two squares, it didn't cost us any moves. It's like, the encumbrance mechanic makes you do dumb stuff like this, so I wish that that were not a thing. Okay, but there's 7 power, that's pretty nice. And someone in this room could see Decker, and likewise this room, so let's put him here. The thing about having 6 agents is just like, where do you put everyone? Finding a safe position to open a door from becomes a challenge. Alright, this door looks pretty good. Yeah. Ooh, there's another door up there, huh? Okay. Well... And this camera, I forgot, by the way, until this very moment, that we're using cycle, and therefore all the excess power that we pick up this turn will do us no good if we can't find a way to use it this turn. Fortunately, however, we could just lockpick this 3 times. We could also dagger it, but that sort of is an inefficient use of power, and we might end up spending less than all of our power, and like, I'd rather spend more power now and save the dagger cooldown because the power's going away anyway, right? And I'd rather not have dagger on cooldown if I don't have to. Okay, so that tells me there's nothing down here that's going to get into this room anytime soon. So this door is the one of concern. I think we will stand to this side of the door and open it.
Those
oh, hello.
Are the same uniforms from the research lab. We've been fighting the same adversary the entire time.
Why did he not go, oh my goodness, I'm looking at this room now? Like, he's staring at the door. He should have said, what? But I guess he didn't because of the little cutscene there? Maybe? Maybe he did and it's just not indicated. I'm going to observe him anyway. No, he's patrolling. To where? To nowhere. I don't approve of this. It's a harbinger as well. So he could be going all kinds of crazy places. I don't like that.
You see that?
Oh, now he's seen me. That doesn't make sense. They're not even supposed to see that. All right. Well, this room is empty. And no one from here is going to be much of an issue. So we could just head back into this room if we wanted, or hide, say, here or here. Here is safest in the short term. Here, there's some slight danger that enemies from this way would perhaps turn the corner and see us. They'd have to get all the way up to here, though, wouldn't they? No, they could come up to maybe here, and that's certainly a possibility. So anyway, here is perfectly fine in the short term, but he would sort of notice us at the corner of his eye, and then we'd have a bit of a tough time getting away, although I suppose we could come here to here, assuming no one else enters the room. So I think I'll go with that. I'll leave Rush here, where she has a good view of this area. Actually, I don't have to commit yet, right? I can have the other agents examine what's going on and then decide what to do with Rush. Central and Monster are, of course, like handicapped beyond belief because they haven't been participating in all the speed upgrades. So mostly this mission, you don't use them. You just try to keep them from messing things up. Oh, wow, look at that gun she's got. Nice model. Just get Monster out of the way as well. And put Prism here. There we go. Now everyone's safe enough that we can open this door. Someone saw that, but I don't know who. Whoa. Okay, it was this guard. He's just an ordinary soldier, so he's got 8 moves. 3, 4... 7, 8, so he doesn't quite get to the door. In fact, he doesn't even get to look around near the door, so if we wanted to, we could... No, we can't move here, of course, silly me. That's a lot of cameras. Okay, well... Tony has the tag pistol, yes? Yes. So we could try some data blasts in this general area. We can get some reasonably good ones. We could also dagger this drone to get a lot more scouting going, which is something that sounds quite appealing to me. So maybe dagger the drone and data blast the 3 cameras. That seems okay. Yes, and we did the dagger first so that we could discover more things to hit with our data blast. I will still use the data blast. It's good value there. Now, there's still this guard. We could... consider pinging him elsewhere, but I think I'm okay with how things are going so far. I'm gonna just overwatch to tag anyone moving. Worst case, that means tagging this guy. Best case, another guard wanders through here before this guy moves and we get a nice little tag on him. And on the other hand, that means leaving the door open, which Decker is, yeah, it's fine. We'll just move Monster down there, and that lets Decker get to here. Now we can leave the door open. There's no way anyone from here is going to see us. Okay, I think I'm okay with that. Rush is keeping the Harbinger busy for a little while at least. Was the door open? No. Oh no. He just caught Rush out the corner of his eye. I got confused. We knew that was gonna happen. Okay.
The mean temperature in Buenos Aires last month was 37
So we're supposed to feel very sorry for Incognita, who's entering senility or something. All right, there's all this whole bunch of guards down here. Do I want to let the guards see the downed camera drone? Eh, I don't think it matters very much. I think I just like to see what's around this corner more than I care about what, yeah, okay, it's a shop. So that's something we could make use of. We have to decide what we're doing about this guard here. We could shoot him, or, you know, otherwise incapacitate him. But that causes alarm level issues, of course. And eventually he'll wake up. You know, we don't have any paralyzers or anything, I don't think. No, just stims and med gels, okay. It might also cause demon issues if we did it with a monster gun. Alternatively, we can just sort of get out of his way. We can even, if we wanted to, sort of hide out this turn, and then next turn have, say, Tony disable his heart monitor, and then have someone else knock him out. So we don't have to suffer the alarm penalty of knocking him out. But we still do suffer the alert guard issue. Meanwhile, Rush has bought herself some time to dodge this guy. We could steal from him to, like, go to the shop, but that's a much lower priority than exploring the level as efficiently as possible for me. I guess stealing from him also has the possibility to yield a security pass card. But that's not my highest priority, really. We won't need one, right? It looks like the security pass cards let us into this room, which is not, I think, going to be the goal. Either of the goal rooms shouldn't have pass cards leading into them, even if there is a normal door. I think it's just a shortcut through this area without going through here. Not very important. So we'll leave that alone. Okay. Fine. That's Rush's turn. We don't really have, we're not in a big rush, in a big hurry to get into this area, which means we're not in a hurry to get by this guard. So I'm going to try the non-violent approach to him and just sort of chip away at all the firewalls while we see what's going on down in the southern corners of the map. And I just want to make sure that we have someone with a sufficient armor piercing that could be Prism. See, he has 3 armor, so one of these guys costs 1 power per point of armor. So it costs all of our power for the turn to use a Neural Disruptor to knock him out. Or we have an overclocked neural dart that would do it. What is this thing with 1 charge? Oh, it's a buster chip. Okay. And we have another neural disruptor somewhere, right? Like, maybe it's Rush who's got the sort of mediocre neural disruptor. Yeah. So this one couldn't do it. And she also has the sort of mediocre gun, and that couldn't do it. So basically I have to choose between spending 3 power, spending 1 ammo on the railgun, or installing a demon if I want to knock this guy out. And I think we can just sort of have Central sit on him, pin him for a while, so that the issue of him waking up is not going to be a huge deal. So I think that that's an okay plan. Well, right. But we said the nonviolent approach. He's not going to be a huge issue, I think, when he leaves. I think we just don't need to mess with him. Let's just get out of the way. and leave him alone, right? I could move Rush here, slightly more efficient. She'll get down to this side of the map faster. But with this camera, there's no hurry exactly. Actually, I want to get to this. I didn't realize we can get to this without disturbing anything. But I'm a little worried about someone coming through this door, so I'm not going to go here. Okay, everyone's in cover, except this camera drone. And there shouldn't be anything back here, right? There might be, though. Looks like a little bit of space there? Yeah, okay. Well, it could be more facility back there, then. All right. Let's try to pay attention to what these guards do down here, because we're about to lose vision on this area. Actually, Decker can find out what they're going to do. Patrolling to there, so he'll see the camera. Patrolling into there, he won't. Okay. All right. Oh, right. They won't see the camera until next turn. Must be jumpy tonight. So they'll see it on the way back, I guess. And I forget, this guy should see it as well. Okay, so Rush... Yeah, does have maximized hacking. So let's hit this area again. That's got most of the cameras, but not the one we need to actually get into the room. We could use the power that we get with Rush here. We're getting 7, which brings us up to 9. We could use that to apply 3 hacks, basically. Say a lockpick here, a data blast here, and a lockpick here. Or, you know, 2 lockpicks in this area so Rush can get going. It doesn't seem exactly urgent to hack this camera because there's a guard standing in the doorway anyway, right? Who is it who has the most anarchy? It's like Decker, right? Yeah. Central's actually not bad. We could have her steal from this guy. We could try pulling this guard further into this room. Rather than letting him go back through here. Say up to here is a possibility. Like, if we have these two break cover and come down to here, and then have Central move up here to distract him and then hide some more. That seems like a pretty cool plan. Means we'd be getting into this area next turn. This area this turn, I guess? Yeah, that sounds pretty good. So let's grab this camera. Now, of course, we could consider just being allowing ourselves to be spotted by the camera, but that doesn't seem like a great plan to me. I'm not really prepared for someone to notice me opening this door. I could run back here if I had to. Yeah, let's go for it. Okay. Nothing of too much interest in here. There is this guy normally patrols back here, but I think he'll notice the drone, so he won't be coming back, if I'm right. Oh, we also don't know what this guy is up to. That is a bit of a bigger problem. Isn't it? If we open the door to find out what he's up to, he'll see that, and he'll come in here, which is not what we want. Can monsters see him from here? No. Huh. Well, maybe we try the subtler approach and just let him get on with his business. Both of these guards. And then head into here next turn. It's possible this guy is coming up through here into this room proper, as opposed to just like passing through. Hopefully he's doing neither of those things and he's like coming down here, who knows. But if he is coming up into here, we can deal with both of these guards if that becomes an issue. So, actually, let's come grab this guy's stuff while we've got him, I suppose. A pass card, okay. Should have made some space in inventory before coming down here so I don't get burdened, but it's fine, I can just get a central to Medgel or something. It occurs to me, if he comes into here, he'll see the people hiding right here, of course. So let's not allow that. That would be a silly way to go, wouldn't it? It's a bit inconvenient to have to make, you know, to have to be so far away from the door with most of our agents. But we have a couple who can get in. That's good enough. Yeah, looking good. And like I said, if we have to, we can deal with those guys, but I'd rather not.
I've got this place locked up tight. See if you can find the security
guard. Okay, so he's coming down.
Should be able to get us past the perimeter defenses from there.
The human brain is a tragically flawed biological machine. It has just enough intelligence to convince itself of its own importance. Its capacity for self-absorption is matched only by its capacity for self-delusion.
So the other concern is this, this thing, right? We can't get in here without triggering it because we haven't found the power supply yet? Or is this it? This is it. Could we handle that? Rush has an EMP that would not help. Magnetic reinforcements. Oh, but this is, okay, so this is the goal area. The second goal. We have to first find the big data bank that Monster can hack into, and then spend some time defending that, and then we have to get Central and Monster, I think? Both down to here. Certainly Central, probably Monster. This is also, like, just a security demon. It's not a big deal. Like, we can trigger it if we have to. Can you tell me? Like, it just says... I recognize what this beam looks like. It should be a security demon, but it's not telling me, actually. It says infrared beam. No, infrared emitter. I don't know. Weird. It should say. So I think, like, we want to get Rush into this room. And it's no big deal. We can open this door, which gets this guard's attention. But we can easily get out of his path. It's just, I don't know exactly what to do with her next. I'd like to get over to this area to apply an EMP to this stuff, even if it doesn't... Ah! The camera is what has magnetic reinforcements, not the power supply. Okay. So how far... is 8 tiles from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is close enough. An EMP here would take out the power supply and beacon the camera. So that's pretty promising. I wonder if this area actually is the... the mainframe access area, the first place we need to get. Let's data blast this, so so that we can get into the room. So we can basically get any three of these as long as we're also hitting, as long as it counts that. I don't care that much about the nanofab, whereas this stuff I kind of do. On the other hand, if we were going to take out this camera with an EMP, we would like to leave it above two firewalls. So that we could take two out via the firewalls, via the EMP, and then hack it to keep it permanently, rather than hack it and then disable it temporarily with the EMP. So it might be good to not hit this. On the other hand, if we're planning to take it with just normal hacking tools, then that doesn't apply. And we'd like to hit. Yeah, I think this is fine. We'll hit. Wait, can I do that? Oh, I can. I thought there was some way I could get this and this without getting this, but it turns out there's not. If I want to get this thing, I have to basically miss the cameras. So okay, fine. Where's Tony? Tony's the one with the access card. He can't actually get in here, but he can get to here and open the door to let someone else in or something, I guess. Say Decker, not Monster. Monster's so useless. While he might not be useless, he's sort of a key asset in this whole operation. Yeah, let's get Decker in here. Tony, do you have a stim still? No. Okay. Well, maybe we had better not mess around too much in this room. I don't know. We can shock trap the door or something if it all goes pear shaped. I think we should be okay. Okay. This doesn't look like the goal room. No, nothing in there at all. Just a shortcut, as I guessed. Well, that's too bad. So, but it tells us we need to go up here, or maybe here. Oh, there's a door. Okay, that's interesting to know. Yeah, so we want to get Rush in here, into this room. In a place where this guy won't be a problem, of course. Let's say here. And then next turn... Oh, actually, this turn we can drop the EMP? No kidding. But I was wrong. This square here is not good enough. It's slightly more than 8 tiles away because of circles. Blech. Okay. Well, in that case, getting Rush any closer is not that useful. We could get her down here, but we already know what's there. Nothing interesting. So let's instead just keep her up here so that she can get to this computer console soon. I guess this room is not just a shortcut into this area, but also into this area without going through the security grid. So he could get in here. By way of this area. So that's something sort of useful. We do need to start making progress with Monster. We can't just leave him lying around. Do we want to bring him up here? I think I'll go here, which is like a reasonable compromise for either north or south. And, wow, Prism has a lot of moves for someone carrying a friggin' railgun. I guess it's those gel injectors, huh? And we'll let Central tag along as well. Nothing much to spend our one power on, unless we wanted to ping a guard for some reason. Which I don't particularly. So we will just overwatch with the tag crystal. Looks good. Yeah, he does turn around. Wait, was he?
Hey, we're checking it out.
I guess our imagination's just getting...
That was a very weird move, going northwest and then southeast. I guess he was trying to get out of the Harbinger's way for some reason, but... Okay, well, I don't like this guy very much. If at all possible, I would like to tag him. I guess we can grab some power with Rush, right? This leaves us with 10. That's 3 uses of a primary hacking tool and 1 tag. That seemed pretty okay. Say, for example, we could get this camera and get back this drone at the same time? Yeah! And hit this shop, but I'm not so happy about that because of the demon. So maybe we'll just do this. Ah, and we're hitting that guard's firewalls as well. How nice. Alright, now we can send this drone to go investigate this door and see if there's anything... see which direction we want to go in. In the meantime... sadly, Tony did not quite get a shot. This one's the Harbinger? Yes, hit him, please. Although, actually, as always, this tag pistol will support multiple uses. Oh, we've tagged them both. So that's not much use. What is this guy up to? We could take the power supply. Sort of EMP this area, maybe? We also have Buster Chips, of course. That triggers a demon. But we get the thing permanently. I think that's probably worth it. We could also get a bunch more power if we wanted, right? 7 more power. I'm not even sure what I would do with all of that. So let's just, for this turn anyway, crack this thing open. What did we get? Blowfish. Oh, that's a little spooky. Okay, well now these guys are doing more exciting things. But at least we have them tagged, so we know about it. Rush, check this guy for me. He's leaving. We're gonna hide here, probably, right? Nope. Alright. I should have had someone else spend the AP on this guy, actually. But okay, we'll just stim out of the way. No big deal. To here? Seems good. Why do we have 7 power? Ah! Central! We have Central on the team. Triggering the demon gives us 5 power. Okay, well... that's exciting. Guess we better find a way to use that, huh? We could apply a hunter to something if we wanted to get this demon database, for example. That could be relatively useful. Or we could just start making progress on this guy's firewalls, but I don't think we plan to knock him out. So let's just hunter this. We don't need to send any pings, because these guys are all going to go into places we're happy for them to be. Yeah, and we can stand right here. We could move into this room to come out down here. I don't know yet which way Monster needs to go, so I'd still sort of rather keep him in the middle. I think he probably wants to go this way. I don't know that, of course. And Central seems to be just fine where she is, I think. Or at any rate, in this room. Decker can make a bit of progress up towards here. Here, please. Okay. Everyone seems good. Nothing left to hack. Okay, I think I'm alright with this. Monster's position is the only one that I'm a little bit concerned about. Or is that... Dr. Shu, I guess. But no, he should be perfectly fine. By the time this guy... Yeah, we'll be fine. What was up there? Didn't see anything.
Investigating. Guess it was nothing.
Investigating area. Guess it was nothing. Okay, good. I'm glad the Harbinger ends his path down there. Oh, I forgot to... We should have people who have spare move points observe guards. Okay, well, let's move the drone first, see what's down here. Okay. Well, I was wrong. We want monsters in this area. Okay, so Central, you have the job of observing many guards, please. It patrols to there. That's a pretty easy patrol to dodge. This guy is going nowhere useful. So is this guy. That's good. And this is the Harbinger. He can go pretty far, but he's also going up to here. It's going to be exciting in that area, I guess. Fine. So we don't know what's going on up here, but we know that we don't really care, right? We just need to get to the southwest corner with Monster. So there's like no guards in this area, right? Yeah. We could even sprint if we wanted, I think. Where's Monster? Here. Sprinting does not get us into a noticeably better position, I don't think. Coming through here is not bad. Oh, hang on. Central, where's Central, please? What is this guy doing next? He's going over here. Yeah, everyone's abandoning the only important thing on the map. That's great. Oh, we don't want to sprint because this guy would hear it? That wouldn't be the end of the world, I guess. Right? It would put him into this room, which is not ideal, but we're leaving this room, right? So who cares? Basically. We want to get started on this. It'd be nice if we had if we'd saved a hunter for that, I suppose. But it'll be off cooldown pretty soon. Let's actually just take the demon database and see which things we care about. Oh, Rubik's, no big deal. Okay. And the blowfish we do care about. Let's see, level 2 guard armor. Where's Monster? Monster's here. We could sprint and get to here. It just doesn't seem that urgent to me. We're doing fine time-wise. We've got hours. None of the guards are on alert, and the only way we could really mess that up is a badly timed sprint, right? So let's not. Well, we'll tag someone as well. Leave, say... Yeah, Decker's a pretty good one to be up here doing all the hacking. This guard should be distracted. I don't think anyone else will be coming down, but just in case, we'll have Decker hide out up here. I'm gonna want Prism to go with Monster for her railgun. and Tony 2. Rush? I don't know. I think I'm happy enough keeping her down here to keep an eye on this area. It's a pretty short path, actually, from here, the first goal, to here, the second goal. And so if we can just keep an eye on this area with Rush, that's fine with me. We need to get Central into this area soon-ish. So maybe we'll move her down here and stop using her as our observer. We could dagger something, I guess? Sure. There you go. Oh! We were going to use that power to tag someone. Oh, well. Not a big deal. I feel a bit silly now that I already forgot that. I wish I could, like, mark the powers, like, please don't use, so I can tag, but whatever. And just for safety, we'll, like, put Monster on Overwatch and Rush on... Yeah, okay. Great. In case somehow someone comes in here... don't Overwatch with Decker, though. There might be guards coming in here, and we don't want to shoot them. We should have daggered... I just pointed at the screen with my finger, by the way. That's a bit silly. Should have daggered this guy, since his firewalls actually impact like how dangerous he is. Oh, I forgot, the drone's down. Okay, well... we can't get Monster there this turn, right? Even if we sprint? Okay. That guard is actually not going to see the downed drone. We left the drone pointing southeast, as I recall, yes. So that's which way he'll be facing when he wakes up, if we allow him to wake up anyway. Yeah, I think Rush should be the one in charge of... Wow, there's a lot of guards up there. In charge of observing guards now, since she doesn't really have anything else to do. Yeah, this guy's patrol path, not important. He's a harbinger, actually, so he could be going further than this. This guy is coming back into here. Important to know about, but not very dangerous. We could even pin this guy if we wanted to, I guess, since we know we won't be spotted. That strikes me as a little dangerous. There we go, got him EMP'd, and come down here. Blowfish, yeah, so I can hack this, but that's rather dangerous and not terribly productive. Yeah, and I think we'll bring Prism down here to be on the ready to incapacitate this guard who comes down to this side of the room. Well, let's check to observe, but yes, that's what he's up to. We could steal from this drone, but we don't really... The power's not that big a deal. We've got Decker standing by to give us all the power we could ever want, just in case. Anything else going on up here? No, this is the end of the map. And we can sort of head central into this room. Should be okay to sprint. He might hear us like on this square or something, but he won't hear us inside this room.
Hold on. Do you hear something?
Yeah. So he's going nowhere terribly useful for him. And we can just leave her in here as a relatively safe path down to here later. Could apply some lockpicks to this guard or save them to do something useful. I think I'll lockpick this guy. The less moving he does, the happier I'm going to be. And we don't really need to like tag this guard, right? I mean, we know what he's up to. We'll have an eye on him for the rest of the game. Armor's going up, but that shouldn't be a big problem.
must be jumping like.
Okay.
High
power installed. And we get power for that because it's implemented as a daemon and we have central. Fine. So we want to get into here this turn. Definitely. If we can. Where is Monster? Did I forget to move him at all? Is that what happened? I think that's what happened. Okay, that's a little embarrassing. Oh well. What exactly are we doing about that? I think we're gonna kill this drone. And knock out this guy. Oh, he has reinforcements. So we didn't kill him. That's fine too. Better, arguably, because now we can keep him pinned instead of we can move him into this room where no one will spot him. As opposed to having to leave him out here in the open. And we can just zot this guy pretty hard, I think. KO for 5 turns, that's pretty good. Oh, was he a Harbinger? Oh, he was. Okay, well, so we got just 2 instead of 4. Having disabled his Heart Monitor. He still has his Consciousness Monitor, I guess is the thing. But no Heart Monitor. Or something? I don't know how it all works, really. Monster, though, you need to get over there, please. Like, quit wasting time. I guess that's here is where we want him. Tony should not be needed in that room. Let's sort of leave him on lookout duty out here. And central, no, this guy's tagged, right? We don't even need him. Okay. So that was a bit of a mistake, but I think it was correct to knock this guy out anyway. His patrol path is a little bit awkward for us. I don't know, actually. It seemed like he was just going back and forth on a short patrol path, even though he was a Harbinger. So I'm not sure what the deal was with that. But, like, he wasn't going to be an issue directly, right away. Once they started getting alerted by this stuff, they would probably have alerted him, and then we would have had to knock him out. Then it was easier to just do it right away. Easier and, I think, safer. Decker and Central, nothing much to do. Let's just get Central to a slightly safer location. Okay. Can't really overwatch with this pistol. Could ping someone if we had to, but we don't, so we'll just float the power. Next turn, Decker will grab the console so we can hunter the thingy before Monster gets into it. Right, there's a lot of power here. Yeah. We'll put a hunter on this, just like for good measure. Before data blasting it down. Monster, yes, you can get there. Very good. And putting the. Putting the drone where Prism is so she can pin the drone and the guard. And also have a good shot at the doorway. speaking of, let's try to position Tony in a defensive position if we can. I guess there's not really much need. Yeah, this guy's just on a normal patrol. Maybe what we ought to do is send Tony in here to unlock this door so that there's 2 paths through for Central. Or alternately not do that, because that makes more paths for guards. Whereas we sort of have as many paths as we need right now, right? So let's just leave Central here, ready to leap into action if necessary. Rush still babysitting this whole area. We have some power to spare. Let's put on this guy. Probably shouldn't leave Decker standing right here, huh? I don't think that would be a very good play. Might as well steal from this guy, actually. I don't remember. We've stolen, but not with Decker, I think, so could find a new item or something. Yeah, looking good. Yeah, we found all the guards, so now it's just a matter of, like, the stuff that happens as a result of this hacking happening. I guess we should start on this, actually. The firewalls are about to go back up. Or not back up, but they're about to go up. So we want to make sure we can get through that in time. Should not be much of a concern. Really, the issue is that they're going to be alerting everyone and sending in more guards to attack Monster. Oh, he's coming in right there, huh?
Reinforcements arrived.
They've noticed us, and they're sending someone to check this terminal. Keep them occupied while I finish.
All right, how about instead of that, you just move over there and he won't see you.
Get back to the terminal.
Now, where was I? Oh, yes. Here.
That's cute. I haven't noticed that voiceover before. Did this guy not come in here? Did I just forget to steal from him, or what's the deal? I don't know. Let's actually get Central even closer to the action. I think we need Monster as well, but it wouldn't hurt to have Central be ready. And we do have access to several terminals that we can hack if we need to get through this in a big hurry, but we shouldn't. Could have tagged this guy, actually. That might have been a better use of our power. So you know what? I'm going to grab this terminal. And use the extra power, not to peek, to go on Overwatch. And may as well grab that and that as well. I don't want to trigger the echo until we're done messing with this thing. Just wanted to get one extra power, and I had to spend the 6 somewhere, so that was as productive a use as any. Oh. He decided to throw a scanner. That's exciting. One guard sent. Yeah, okay. So they're sending through a lot of guards now. Okay, this is where it starts to get exciting.
What the hell was that? I know we're in the building now. Just give me a bit more time.
So he's gonna throw another. Okay. He's gonna just throw another camera in because his last one revealed a. Or not because his last one did, but because of the thing that scanned us. Okay, well, that's actually kind of fine. Right? We can. Oh, first of all, we have power to steal whenever we need it. Means we can leave this guy alone for a little while. Tony also has a choice to make. We could either disable this guy's heart monitor or tag this guy. Can't really do both. Let us let us see, what are we gonna do? I can go into Overwatch, correct? Yes, okay. I wasn't sure about the pinning. Overwatch, you can't ambush when you're pinning someone. I wanted to make sure you could Overwatch. You know what, actually, this episode's gone on for a little while, and I think we've got a little while left to go. So I'm gonna call a break here, and come back for the thrilling conclusion of this Invisible Ink episode / series. Thrilling conclusion one way or another. Hopefully victory. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.